There is a lot we don't know about space since it's really hard to get out there and explore, but you know what we can do? Send things into space. A lot of things. Just like a lot. We've sent so much into space. Hey, most amazing fam. Today, I'm sharing with you all the top 10 mysterious objects found in our solar system because we've sent just a ton of stuff into space, and I feel like you deserve an explanation on why and how it got there. And my name is Abby, your host. But before we get into that, let me remind you that we have a contest going on. Why would we send stuff into space when we could send it to you? Cue party horn sound effect again. Now, you could win a signed Most Amazing t-shirt and $200! Anyways, what do you have to do? How tough will this task be to win? Well, mere moments will be taken from you, my friend. Now, go follow our Facebook page, like and comment on our video, guess that YouTuber challenge, and that's it. You'll be entered. Easy peasy. So, this contest runs until Thursday, December 5th, and the winner will be drawn on the 6th, so go on and enter. What do you got to lose? Nothing. They'll be sent to you, not space, I promise. Also, of course, peep the new YouTube channel, Top 10 Central, and yes, I'm gonna keep plugging it because it's that good, okay? Thank you. Go support those hosts, thank you. All right, now, without further ado, let's see what's been sent into space. At number 10, we have Luke Skywalker's lightsaber. And you think space, and where does your mind go? Star Wars or Star Trek? Well, congratulations if it's the former, because a little bit of Star Wars spent a little bit of time in space. Back in 2007, the space shuttle Discovery launched the STS-120 astronaut crew with an iconic prop on board with them. The lightsaber Mark Hamill used as Luke Skywalker back in Star Wars back in 2007 joined real astronauts in orbit for 2 whole weeks. An astronaut named Jim Riley said that there is a fine line between science fiction and reality, and the lightsaber served as a neat little link between the two space themes. Just imagine, they said they didn't open it, but if they did, they probably, like, let's be real, they did. They just opened it and they were like, phew. That's what I would. But let's go on to number 9, a corned beef sandwich. Now, if you're gonna go on a trip into space, you know it's gonna be a long one. And astronauts, they don't get the best food on board, getting most of their food freeze-dried or just nutrients they suck out of a pouch. But astronaut John Young was hoping for something just a little bit tastier. On March 23rd, 1965, John smuggled a corned beef sandwich on Flight Gemini 3. He got the sandwich from fellow astronaut Wally Shearer, who bought it from a Cocoa Beach, Florida deli. Now, because of the low gravity on the flight, it began to disintegrate when John took a bite, but he did say it was pretty good and just if it would hold together, you know? All my sandwiches fall apart anyways, sadly. Anyways, another thing that made its way into space, at number 8 we have a saxophone. Now, for his birthday in 2007, Thomas Pesquette got a fun musical gift, his own saxophone. But it wasn't an ordinary delivery since Thomas lived on SpaceX's cargo craft at the time. It was delivered on the SpaceX Dragon alongside some French macaroons for his birthday. And yeah, he said he's a little out of practice since he stopped playing while he was training to be an astronaut, but isn't that cool? Once the workday is done, I can imagine that floating in space, you know, could get a little boring after a while. But if you have some smooth, jazzy tunes on a woodwind to keep you going, it'll all be all right. You know? You like jazz? Keep the beam references in. Okay. At number 7, piece of a plane. When Neil Armstrong went to the moon in 1969, he brought a little piece of a plane with him. And not just any plane too, but a piece of the rudimentary airplane the Wright brothers flew in 1903 when the aircraft came a few feet off the ground. Now, Neil had with him some of the fabric and some of the propeller of the Wright Flyer, and this was as a homage to pioneers that paved the way in aviation and beyond. Which, of course, all makes sense because the Wright brothers Flyer 1 was the first successful heavier-than-air powered aircraft. And so, you gotta respect those who came along before you, you know? All right, get ready for it. This one's special. At number 6, we have dirt. And yeah, okay, obviously it's not just any dirt, but it is dirt. The dirt that did go into space came from the pitcher's mound at Yankee Stadium. And you might be thinking, why, Abby? So basically, Garrett Reisman is not only an astronaut, but also a huge Yankees fan. And he was flying on Space Shuttle Endeavour's STS-123 mission back in 2008, and astronauts are allowed to bring mementos, so he thought, hey, why not bring up a little bit of dirt from the stadium of my favorite team? And it seems worth it when you find out he also threw the first ceremonial first pitch from space in microgravity. So the man's dedicated and he's gonna go down in history, so. Seems good to me. Now, the next one hasn't just traveled into space, but it has stayed there. At number 5 is the fallen astronaut. Now, not all people who went to the moon made it back safely. It is a risky job to be an astronaut after all. So now, resting on the moon is a small aluminum figurine by Belgian artist Paul van Hooydonk. It is stylized to try to depict an astronaut in a spacesuit as a way to commemorate those who have passed in the advancement of space exploration. It was put on the moon in 1971 next to a plaque listing 14 American and Soviet men who were known to have died at that point. This was organized by astronaut David Scott before his Apollo 15 lunar mission, and now it serves as a nice tribute to all those who give their life to space. And now, people haven't been the only mammals to not make it through a space mission, which brings me to number 4. Lots of dead space monkeys, many called Albert. Now, before people were sent into space, animals were used to test the waters. Or the space. Now, in the US, monkeys or chimpanzees were used for this, and many were named Albert. After the first one they named Albert, they just decided to keep that name going. In some cases, when the apes passed away, the spacecrafts weren't reported as recovered, which has led people to believe that there may be some space junk out there with some monkeys still in them. Now, not all space places used monkeys back then. During the space race, the Soviets were using dogs to see how the atmosphere would affect creatures, which obviously sparked many heated debates on animal testing, but they don't do that anymore, so. Now, let's move on to a lighter note, sports! At number 3, we have a golf ball. On the Apollo 14 trip, Alan Shepard decided to bring a couple of golf balls with him on his trip to the moon. He decided, hey, I'll take a few shots on the moon, so he attached a modified 8-iron club head to the end of a device that traditionally collects samples of moon dust, and then he just let her rip. Now, video footage shows that he missed the mark a few times and hit the ground before hitting the ball, but come on, can we really blame the guy? Gravity is different on the moon, so you have to give a guy some time to adjust, right? He sent one 200 yards, which, you know, isn't too bad, but then he sent another one for what he said went on for miles and miles. So one scientist did the math and said Alan was right. With the right hit, a golf ball could be sent about 2.5 miles. So at that point, that's quite a bit more than the world record of 515 yards, and I just wanna say, Dad, can you do better than that? Just kidding, love you, Dad. Okay, bye. Let's move on to number 2, Buzz Lightyear toy. I mean, action figure, whatever you call it, okay? So, to infinity and beyond, and to infinity and beyond good old Buzz Lightyear went. Back in 2008, an action figurine of the Toy Story astronaut hopped aboard the International Space Station with Discovery Mission STS-124. He had a jolly old time, possibly missing some other toys to hang out with, but returned 15 months later on STS-128. So now, before Lightyear went on his journey, he was even given the all clear to go by the other Buzz astronaut, Buzz Aldrin. In a promo video for NASA, Buzz Aldrin even told Buzz Lightyear that he, Buzz Aldrin, was the real Buzz. And yes, it's true. Buzz Lightyear's name was inspired by Buzz Aldrin, so this second man to step out on the moon has a legacy more than the moon, also Buzz Lightyear. Toy Story. Yes. But let's finish up with number 1, tardigrades, or water bears. So if you're wondering what these things are, haven't heard it through the grapevine, let me break it down for you. Tardigrades are very tiny, yet microscopic, 8-legged creatures that are known to survive extreme temperatures. They can withstand being heated to 150 degrees Celsius and frozen to almost absolute zero. So knowing this, scientists did experiments with tardigrades and found out that some could withstand being in the vacuum of space. And this is because they can be brought back to life decades after being dehydrated, or it's at least possibly connected to that. So right now, there are some of these tardigrades, aka water bears, aka moss piglets, on the moon. Now this is since an Israeli spacecraft crash landed on the moon this April. Also, some people think they are still alive, so maybe they'll be the first inhabitants on the moon. That'd be kinda cool, little bears. Microscopic, but yeah. Now, all right, that is all I have that is in our solar system. My name is Abby, that was the top 10 mysterious objects found in our solar system, and we've brought or put so much stuff into space, even more than I could fit on this list. Cause like seriously, the amount of music or sound sent into space could entertain aliens just out there for a while. I'm kinda jealous of how much they get sent. You know, someone make me a mixtape, like they mix one for the aliens. Now, have you heard of anything else out there? Let me know down below, and while you're down there, give us a like and subscribe, and ring that bell to make sure you get notifications. Remember to check out Top 10 Central and our Facebook page for more, or throw in a playlist. Until next time, space out. Okay. Bam, bam, okay. The arms are going wild tonight. We're gonna be getting a lot of comments.